In this video, I'm going to show you how to combine n8n, Home Assistant, and Frigate's face recognition to build an AI family clock-in system that automatically creates a daily attendance sheet of when everyone gets home. First things first, let's enable Frigate's brain. In your Frigate config file under your camera settings, you need to ensure two things are enabled: tracking for person objects and the face recognition feature itself. Save it, restart, and you're good to go. If you need a full guide on installing Frigate, I've got a video linked for you up above. With that done, you'll see a new Faces tab in your Frigate UI. This is your face library. To get started, you'll click Add Face, give it a name like Father, and upload a few photos. I recommend at least 3 clear, unobstructed shots, one looking straight ahead, one from the left, and one from the right. Now, for the first few days, your system might still label your family as unknown, because the AI is still learning. When that happens, just find the snapshot, click Train Face in the bottom right, and assign it to the correct person. This is how you continuously improve its accuracy over time. I've already set up libraries for dad, mom, and son, so we can jump right in. All right, let's build the n8n workflow. Our starting point is a schedule trigger. We want this report daily, so we'll set this to run once every day at a time when everyone is usually home, like midnight. This is the set it and forget it part of our automation. Once midnight strikes, the first thing our workflow needs to do is gather all of today's attendance data. For that, we use the HTTP request node, which I've renamed attendance record. So what's the common mistake here? People might try to use a simple Home Assistant node to get the current state of the face sensor, but that's useless. We need the whole day's history. The right way is to query Home Assistant's database API directly. Let's look at the setup. The method is get. The URL is a dynamic expression that tells Home Assistant to start its search from the beginning of the current day. Since this is a protected API, you need to set the authentication to header off and create a new credential using your Home Assistant long-lived access token. Finally, in the query parameters, we add 2 filters. One, filter entity ID, to tell it we only want the history for our Frigate face recognition sensor, and an end time parameter to define the end of our search window. This node now acts as our private investigator, pulling the complete raw log file for the day. But that raw log is messy. It's full of unknown, unavailable, and other useless states. We only care about the names we recognize. That's the job of our third node, a code node I've named Face Filter. It acts as a high-precision filter. The JavaScript code inside is simple. It looks at every single record from the previous step and only keeps it if the state matches one of the names in our family list, dad, mom, or son. This cleans out all the noise and leaves us with a perfect list of just the important events. Now, while this is optional, I highly recommend this next step for debugging, a data table insert row node, which I've called attendance sheet. Its job is to take that clean list of arrivals and save a permanent copy inside n8n's own database. Why? Because if your AI report ever looks strange, you'll have this raw, clean data log to come back to and diagnose the problem. It's the black box for our automation. To set it up, just create a new data table, name it attendance sheet, and add 3 columns: entity, member, both as string, and date. Then, back in the node, just select the data table and map the outputs from the previous node, entity ID, state, and last updated, to the correct columns. Okay, before we send this data to the AI, we need to make it as easy as possible for the AI to understand. That's where the Edit Fields node comes in. We'll do two things. First, we'll transform the raw state, like dad, into a more descriptive member dad. Second, we'll reformat the long, ugly timestamp into a clean arrival time. This is like highlighting the important parts of a document before handing it to your boss. It ensures the AI knows exactly what it's looking at. With our data formatted, we now have a series of individual arrival events. But to get a complete report, the AI needs to see the whole picture at once. That's the job of the aggregate node. It simply waits for all the individual records, dad's arrival, mom's arrival, to pass through and then bundles them all into a single, complete list for the day. We can't feed the AI one event at a time. We have to give it the complete dossier. And now for the main event. We hand that complete dossier to the AI agent node. This is our connection to Google Gemini. We give it a clear and specific prompt like, "You are an attendance expert. Based on the family arrival records I'm providing, generate a concise daily attendance report." We even explain the data format to it. The AI reads our structured data and creates a human-readable summary. The report is ready, but it's still stuck inside n8n. We need to get it out. First, we'll use a call a service node, which I've renamed notification. We'll configure this to call the persistent notification service in Home Assistant. For the message, we'll just pipe in the output from our AI agent. This creates a permanent time-stamped record of the report right in our Home Assistant dashboard. But what if you want it on the go? We add another call a service node, this one called message. This time, we set the domain to notify and the service to our specific mobile phone. The message is the exact same AI output. And that's it. Congratulations. Your smart home now officially holds a morning meeting with itself every night to gossip about what time everyone got home. All the resources and code for this project are linked for you in the description. Drop a comment with your ideas for what I should build next. Thanks for tuning in. Your support through likes and subscribes is a massive help and allows me to create more content like this. Until next time, happy automating.